tackle the topic on why is Good Friday good from Mark chapter 14, verse 53 to Mark chapter 15, verse 15. Number one, Jesus was unfairly accused. And we can see that from Mark chapter 14, verses 53 to 65. Jesus was betrayed by one of his disciples. His name was Judas Iscariot. Now, Jesus' disciple betrayed him and he was arrested. He was taken to trial by religious people who were jealous of him. There are a few more things that I would like all of us to understand here. Number one is that the trial that they were putting together here was first and foremost illegal. Secondly, it was happening on a public holiday. It was happening on the day of the Passover in the middle of the night. And it was happening and taking place, this trial was taking place in the house of the high priest. Now, this is extremely weird. The reason why they wanted to do this very quickly was because the religious authorities wanted to very quickly get Jesus out of the way. You see, we assume that wrongly accusing Jesus may have only happened 2,000 years ago in that time, in that scene. But the truth is, even today, there are many people who unfairly accuse Jesus of things that he's not. Some people say that Jesus is a myth, like the Greek mythology, gods like dragons and phoenixes. Jesus Christ is just a myth, it's just a story. Some people say that, maybe he's a historical figure. He walked this earth. Maybe he existed, but he's just a man. Some people maybe say that, maybe Jesus is God, but there are other gods. And every religion is the same. Many people that make false claims and accusations about Jesus, even today, they haven't read much or heard much about who this Jesus really is. What I encourage you to do is to really go and do your research, investigate the claims, and see and come to a conclusion based on what you have seen and read. Number two, Jesus was abandoned. And we can see this from verses 66 to 72. In this scene, as Jesus was being arrested and accused wrongly and taken and beaten and spat on, in that moment, there was another guy in close vicinity. His name was Peter. In the greatest time of need of Jesus, his closest friend, his closest disciple abandoned him in his time of need. Jesus, your Lord and your Savior, your Master and your King, he too was abandoned in his time of need. And if you've been abandoned before, then God just wants to let you know that you're not alone and he's there for you. And that God, His presence, His Spirit is in you and He will never leave you, He will never forsake you. But, you know, not just have we been abandoned before, some of us, but the truth is, many of us, we are actually guilty of abandoning Jesus too. We too have abandoned Jesus. Many times when it's convenient to be associated with Christ, we say, we declare our loyalty, but just as quickly, just like Peter, when times get tough, when times get rough, when it is difficult to acknowledge our faith, do we stand firm? Even when we're going to be ridiculed, mocked, judged, even when we're going to be marked down, will we still stand firm in our faith and in our value? And the third scene happens the next morning. They did this trial in the middle of the night, through the early morning, and now we reach the next morning on what we remember as Good Friday morning. And on this scene, the religious authorities, they brought Jesus before this person called Pontius Pilate. Now, Pontius Pilate is the Roman governor of this place. Okay, so Pontius Pilate is the Roman governor. The reason why the religious authorities had to bring Jesus before Pontius Pilate is because the Jewish authorities had no power to execute anyone. They could punish people according to their own laws, but they cannot execute and kill, sentence anyone to death. Only the Roman governor could do that. Therefore, they needed the help of the Roman governor to pronounce Jesus as guilty. The crowd was so fixated, so blinded by their desire to crucify Jesus and sentence him to death, that they were willing to release a notorious murderer back into their society so that they could sentence Jesus to death. Pilate was so afraid of his own power and not allowing a riot to take place that he was willing, even though he knew that this guy had created, he had done nothing wrong. He knew that Jesus had not done anything wrong, but yet he was so afraid of losing his power that he would release and order the release of the known murderer Barabbas. The truth is, some of us here today, in our society today, some of us here, we may know that Jesus is God. We may know that Jesus is the Son of God. We may know that this Jesus is real. But the truth about us is that because we are so fixated on our own agenda, we're so fixated on the kind of life that we want to live, the kind of things that we want to do, and the kind of things we don't want to do, and we ignore Jesus so that we can have the agenda that we are fixated on. Even if we don't pursue God, He will never stop pursuing us. Even if we ignore God, He will never ignore us. We'll never reach a point where we can ignore God so much that He gives up on us. God is pursuing us. And I want final verse from John chapter 3, verse 16. And I want to invite everyone to read it out together in full voice. 1, 2, go. For God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son, that whoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have eternal life. And as we approach Good Friday, we remember that Good Friday is good not because it's a long weekend. Good Friday is good because it was very, very, very bad for Jesus. He was unfairly accused. He was abandoned by His closest friends. He was ignored. But because of what Jesus had done for us, Good Friday is good for us because we have forgiveness of sins, a relationship with God, and eternal life. And this morning, I want to just invite you, let Good Friday not just happen as an occasion next Friday, but let Good Friday happen in your heart. And if you are far from God, will you come back to God this Good Friday?